My name is Ozioma Ejiofor of Solid 100.9 FM.
Okay.
It's about the way and manner men try to either hoard their daughters in a guise of protecting them. You see your daughter standing with a man and you're so uncomfortable. And the next thing, she's pregnant. We don't know how that happens. So I ask, is it a better way to always bully the girl child because a guy came to look for her in your home? Wouldn't you rather appreciate it that the guy came to your house to look for your daughter than you seeing her hanging out late hours just to prevent being beaten? Thank you very much.
The man talking to me about what we actually started and we want. Let me share my experience. During courtship, I told my then wife to be, over 20 years after we are still friends, I said, if God gives us children, because for me, marriage is different from family. Marriage is for two. Family is if you now get neighbors. I call them neighbors so that we can love them as we love ourselves.
Yes.
I said, if God gives us children, want to know their boyfriend or girlfriend as early as 15, 16, she said, God forbid. You know, we are religious people. Your pastor is a pastor. I said, what do you mean God forbid? He said, our children will not have boyfriend or girlfriend. I said, then you are setting the best in advance for what you will not be able to control. Eventually, she changed when she understood. So, I'm saying, I'm supporting you, that we do it already, so that don't go misrepresent us here, because the organizer said, this is for me.
Thank you very much, Yellow Group. Thank you. Please put your hands together for them. It's the Orange Group. Please join
the podium to speak. And I said, I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus. Before I finished Christ, I said, no. In Yoruba, they say, which means let's use the devil first before you now use God. Under the circumstance, God is the only person that I had and I held on to, and it helped me. So it's always good for women to pray. Stay upright. It's a pity that it's men here, but if you have such situation, the best thing is to tell the women, be upright. If you are married, stay with your husband. If you are not married, stay with your God. God answers prayers. Even in politics, God does answer prayers. And all that one needs to do is that you don't need to spend so much money. There is a lady who was wife of the chairman of Kaduna State. I can't remember her name now. She worked with her husband. The husband was chairman of the local government. So time came to participate. The women went and said, come, let's go. What happened? They were having meetings. The women will bring kunu, they will bring kunuzaki and all those things that they need to drink. She didn't need to spend money. And when it was time, they were the ones that helped her because her husband's family and all those people didn't want her to go. But the women supported her. So actually, it's good for one to be steadfast. You stay to be who you are. You stay with your God. That's very, very important. And then, if it's possible, we're trying to mentor some women who have so much money that they can. 5, 6 will come together, you support the man. It's not so with the women. And in most cases, when you finish, you remove your tie, you share your beer and all that. It's not so with women. We women still need to learn what men do to support women, to support each other.